Hi, my name is Gareth Pronovost, and I help people unlock the full potential of Airtable. I have a small consulting firm called Gap Consulting, and that business started about a year ago, and about 6 months into that journey, I started releasing these YouTube tutorials on Airtable, and it really started to take off from there. And so basically what I do is I just help people visualize the different things that are possible in Airtable by building them here in YouTube videos. And that's what brings me to you all here today. So in this video, we're going to be doing a quick breakdown on how to build a CRM for personal use inside of Airtable. I'm going to be going through this step by step. And the part that makes Airtable so useful is that you can it's so modular that you can make changes wherever you see fit. So if you follow along on this video and build this for yourself, and then you say, hey, maybe I don't need that, or maybe I want something else instead. Totally possible, very easy to do. So without further ado, let's jump on into this and take a look. All right, so when you first log into Airtable, and I should point out that this is a free account that I am sharing with you here, you'll see a screen very similar to this. When you are ready to create a new space, it's called a base, and that is short for database. So inside here, we're just going to click Add a Base, and you'll see that we can start with a template. And if we select to start with a template, it's going to take us to Airtable Universe, which has just a list of all these different templates that other people have built and shared. But for this case, we're actually going to start from scratch. You see that you also have an option, of course, of importing a spreadsheet. So if you already have some sort of data that you've been tracking in a spreadsheet, you could actually start from there. But I'm going to start from scratch for this example. And I'm going to just call this the example CRM. And you'll see that you can also pick, a logo or something to kind of identify this space. So let's see. I know that there's a people logo. Find that one. And you can change the color. It's all very customizable. So now we've got this built. Let's go ahead and jump into it and take a look at how that is set up. So when we go inside, you'll see that we have one table here. Table is like a tab in Excel, and then we have these three fields, and fields are columns. So real quick rewind here, there is some Airtable terminology you need to know. Field is a column, a record is a row, and a table is essentially a tab. And all of the tables can be linked together so that they share information between them, and I will show you an awesome use case for that in this video. So let's go ahead and rename this table, and we're going to call this our contacts. And so what different pieces of data are we going to collect on every contact? Well, I'm going to make this very generic, and of course, as I mentioned, you can customize this for yourself however you need. But we're going to have a full name here. I'll just keep it name, and I'm going to get rid of these notes and attachments fields. And a very common use case would be to have a first name and a last name. You get that set up right here. And we can actually build it so that name is, you know, the full name, and that this is going to be a formula that adds the first and last name together. So let's see how we would do that. What I'm doing here is selecting the type of data that lives in this field. So you see that you have a list of different types of data that can be selected. And we're going to go ahead and select the formula. And for this one, we're going to use a concatenate formula. And inside these parentheses is where we're going to tell it what different pieces of data we want to string together. In this case, we're going to string together the first name. And then we separate each field by a comma. And then I'm going to put a space. And I need to surround it in these quotations so that it recognizes that that's a space. And then we're going to put the last name. So that's a very similar syntax to what you would write in Excel, except you don't need an equal sign in front of it. You just begin typing the formula. And so that's it. That's how we would write these formulas. And let's do a quick test run. Let's say we had Wyatt Earp in here. If we enter that name and we give Airtable a moment to think, it will populate. Perfect. Now we need to start thinking about the different things that we want to collect, the different data points that we collect for all of our different contacts. A very standard one would be email. And you see that the default field type is a single line text. Well, now we are going to actually select this to email. And a quick side note, you'll notice that there are many, many different types of field types here that were not visible when I was showing you the formula earlier. So really quickly, let me select that email, but then I'm going to jump into this other one. We're going to look at the different field types here. This is a much shorter list, and this is because this first field is called the primary field, and there are a limited number of different types of fields that you can have here. Because it's the primary field, this is what will drive all of the connections that we build into this table, and so it needs to be a unique name in as many cases as possible. So just bear that in mind when you're setting up the architecture for your own space. You can see that I'm also very easily resizing these columns or fields, and so I'm trying to keep it nice and tidy. And so here's where, you know, we might have different email information. All right, and so what other fields might we have? Well, we might need a phone number. And you, again, you see, I think the point here is just to show you that you can really easily customize the type of data that lives here. If you are based in the US, this phone number field works really well. And otherwise, it might be a little difficult to get it to set up. I've worked with clients in the past that are not US-based, and their phone number always comes in a little funky. So just bear that in mind. This is set up to have a 10-digit phone number. And so you can just add all these different things into this database. Anything that you want, you could add notes, you could add, you know, a status, maybe like a lead status, like, you know, hot, cold, something like that. All of this is very easily customizable inside of Airtable. What we're actually going to do is build another table that we're going to connect into the contacts. And that table is going to be our interactions. So this is how, in a CRM, this is the basic functionality. We need to store the data of individuals and organizations. And then we also need to store the information about how we have interacted with those individuals. And so that's what we're going to have here. So we're going to create a new table. And we're going to name this table Interactions. And you see that the table starts off with the same three fields that the last one did. We're going to get rid of all of these. And I'm just going to call this the interaction ID. And I'm going to keep it single line text for now. And I'm going to change that in a moment. And we're going to have a type of interaction. And for this one, we actually use the single select option. And the single select option is like a drop down, essentially. So let's take a look at what that might look like. Different types of interactions we could have would be email, in person, phone, and you can, you know, add new task types as you see fit here. And then over here, we're going to have the any notes from this, and this will be a long text field. And of course, most importantly, we need to record who we have that interaction with and when the interaction is. So this is going to be where we start linking tables. And you'll see that you have an option to link to another record. And we can choose, are we linking to a record inside the interactions table, or are we linking to a record in a different table? In this case, the contacts table. And that's what we want. So we're going to select that and we're going to save. And we're going to add one more thing, and that will be the date of interaction. All right, so let's see, and lastly, of course, I want to make this a unique interaction ID. And so I'm gonna write a quick formula for this. And you'll see that when we first write this, of course, this is going to flash as an error, because we don't have the data in the fields. So let's go ahead and throw some data in these fields and set up an example just to test this all out. and it looks great. So I'm going to get rid of these. So effectively what we have here is, you know, this is recording the interaction, and it's getting the name of both the type, the contact, and the date. And the nice thing about that is it is going to be easy to see when we jump back into contacts. So let's see what the reciprocal of this relationship is, because now we built this relationship between the interactions and the contacts. And so not only does the contact live on the interactions table, but the interactions now live on the contacts table. And the reason that we want to give that a unique primary field, remember the primary field is the far left column. The reason we want that to be such a unique name is because now we can very easily see what this interaction is by that name. And that's it. So as you, you know, build this out for yourself, of course, as I've said multiple times already, you will want to change this and customize it for your own personal needs. However, in this case, this is just a really simple basic layout for how you would build both contacts and then also interrelate them with interactions. So before we sign off here, I'm just going to show you how you would enter new data into this. Of course, the advanced use case would be using Zapier automation so that this information was being taken from some part of your business and entered into this database automatically. But if we're not that advanced, we can do this manually. So we start off by clicking that plus to add a new record. And of course, we don't need to type the full name. That's going to be assumed automatically. Let's go ahead with Doc Holliday. And we have to give Airtable a moment to catch up. And there it's filled out the name for us. Any information that we put in here will be recorded for Doc. And so now jumping back into our interactions, if we had an interaction with Doc that we wanted to record, we would click the plus down here, adding a new record. And we would add the date for that. Let's suppose that was today. And of course, we need to select who we had the contact with. And you'll see that whereas before we just saw Wyatt Earp, now we see Doc Holliday here. And whatever type of interaction that was, maybe that was on the phone. And any notes that we wanted to take, we could just start typing. And there we are. And if we jump back into our contacts, we will see that we have this last contact here. Last piece that I want to leave you with is how you could add multiple contacts or multiple interactions and then pull back information that showed you when you had your last contact. So let's build an old one for Doc Holliday as well here. Let's suppose that we had spoken to Doc Holliday in early December as well. So we have two interactions for Doc. We have one on the 11th and one on the 30th. So jumping forward into contacts, we would see now both of those interactions are recorded. But what we want to do is bring in a new field that is going to show us the most recent interaction, date. And this is called a roll-up field. And what it's going to do, it's going to look at all of those interactions on the interaction table, and we want it to tell us which one is the latest date. So we look at interactions table, we want to look at the date, and we want to know what the latest one is, which is a max values function. Once we've done that, you'll see that we don't see that 12/11 recording. We only see the date for the most recent interaction that we recorded with Doc Holliday and with Wyatt Earp. So this is pertaining directly to these interactions here, and it's doing the math basically and finding out which of these is the interaction that is the most recent. So I will leave you with that. If you have any further questions or want to learn Airtable in greater detail, I welcome you to swing by my YouTube channel and visit my website. I put out a lot of content, new content every week, to help people really unlock the full potential of this software. So I hope to see you there, and thanks for your time.